with, not a judge anymore. But I love Tessin Ombudsman of Karnataka, because we're like that for 5 years, which has entirely changed my life and my outlook towards life. You would have noticed not many judges after retirement come to streets and my dance. I have come now, and Anas has moved into place. I participated in the protests as held in Delhi as well as delegated in Bagan. That's because of the fact in 5 years' experience, I saw so much of injustice, my administration, sufferings of the people of Karnataka, that I decided whatever may be my past status in society, I must fight against these evils that's there. India's educational system has made Indians very intelligent, ready to become successful entrepreneurs. But somewhere down the line, I think education system and the social values changed. While education became purely giving ideas to succeed professionally, the social values changed. I suppose success and social values do not go together. It's for this purpose I have decided to speak to the masses, try and enlighten them of the mistake that is being committed. Therefore, I have been to more than 500 education institutions, talked to the youths, interacted with the youths. I have been learned a lot, and I hope even if 10% of the youth change their attitude and confine their desires in life to what they have legitimately, I think India will become another successful story. I sincerely appeal to students, have ambition, grow, become successful, become rich, but don't allow that ambition to become an obsession. Legitimately earned wealth is no product of sin. Otherwise, it is very much. It is to spread this message. I've been through, as I said, more than 500 educational institutions and interacted with students. And this morning, I was there in Government Law College, Karnataka, and this is one message that I have. India may be a developed country, but in the process, it has also produced many people who are, according to me, have either become inhumans or have not become humans having been born as homosexuals. The experience I gained with Rogai shows how inhuman people can be in the greed of money. I had a case in hand where a garment servant, a doctor, a pediatric surgeon, refused to operate on a child which had a part of the lower intestine missing, because of which the child was eating through the mouth and defecating through the mouth. And this doctor had the necessary knowledge to give help to that child, but demanded to use some which the child and the parents of the child couldn't afford. He brought the child to my office. I didn't want him to send the child to a government hospital. So I gave letters of recommendation to private super specialty hospitals. Not that they are any better, but just to make an experiment and see. And they operated, one of the hospitals in Bangalore operated, the child is perfectly upright. I gave this example for you to judge. This doctor, who had the necessary qualification and knowledge to give relief to this child, did not do that, even though he was working in a government hospital and drawing salary in the government, and the hospital was meant for the poor. What sort of a people are these? Are we human beings if we are to stoop to that level? You get enough money, at least in Karnataka, you know. They get nearly about 55,000 to 70,000 rupees basic salary, and 55% of that basic salary comes as general salaries, house rent benefits, leave, permanency in job. But when it comes to rendering help to somebody who is in desperate need of help, why? Because that person is suffering from a disease which I term it as greed over need disease. That disease has no cure. My appeal to you, my dear students, is, as I said earlier, develop an attitude of contentment, satisfaction with what you have digitally. Everybody can develop that satisfaction. It gives you great pride when you can at least tell yourself, I'm honest, I do my job, I take my responsibility seriously. That should be the attitude. See the growth of corruption in this country. The first scam that came out was called the Jeep scam in 1948. 70 lakhs was the amount that is what could have been lost to the country. 1986, both the same. 64 crores. 2010, 2G. 1,76,000 crores. 2012, okay. 1,86,000 crores. Can this country really, really develop? With that much of money being siphoned up in the system, what's the consequences? In 2007, the CAG reported to the Government of India that out of the lakhs and lakhs of crores of rupees given by the Government of India for the benefit of the rural poor for implementation of aid schemes, mid-day-meal scheme, integrated child development scheme, drinking water scheme, supply of electricity, primary health center, primary education, underground drainage, and gram sadak yojanas. For such like schemes, the Government of India gave lakhs and lakhs of crores of rupees to the state governments. And the CAG reports for the year 2006-2007, 51,000 crores of rupees were unaccounted for. And the Government of India wrote to the CAG and said, this money has been given by us to NGOs. They have not accounted for it. Who do we look for? In 1988, then the Prime Minister went Rajiv Gandhi said, for every rupee the government gives, the beneficiary gets only 15%. Imagine if all that money, which is earmarked for the purpose of development, reaches the beneficiary in its entirety. What development would have been there in this country? It's not happening. That is why I go around imploring upon the youth and the students, you alone can bring the change, not people of my age. We are the ones who brought the change for bad. You have to not change that thing, reverse it. Don't be under the impression your individual efforts will not pay. Everywhere I go to the internet, they say, what can I do alone? My integrity will change the corruption in this country. It is well said that a journey of 1,000 miles starts from the first step. And from the person who takes that first step. This I am adding to that. If every one of you think you can do this much of contribution of talking against corruption, being honest with yourself, I think it will bring you a tremendous amount of change in the society I have been. Enough is enough. Do not respect them. Do not felicitate them. If you don't want to boycott them, keep away from them. Let them feel that they are ignored. Then they will feel that they are not wanted. That's the best punishment they can do. Oaths and punishments. I've seen it. The speed in which justice delivery system functions doesn't create any fear in the mind of the corruption. In Karnataka, it takes minimum 12 years in the first school. Oh, you know, in Karnataka, in Delhi. In 1996, you come, the central minister was caught by the CBI with 3.5 crores of rupees cash in his mattress. He was charged with it in 1996. He was punished by the first court in 2009. Where is that fear of conviction? Where is it? Conviction is supposed to be a deterrent. It seems to be one. Society should step in. Keep these people away. However powerful they may be, refuse to participate in them. I think you can bring about a lot of changes. A. Greed converts a human being into a greedy man. B. People's suffering knows no bound. Let me give you one example, I said that sometime. In 2010, I saw a photograph of a lady in one of the vernacular newspapers in Bangalore. That picture depicted a lady sitting in a desolate place with a pot next to her and scraping the top soil with her bare fingers. An article below that said she has walked 4 kilometers. And if she gets a pot of water in respect to the quality of the water, she is lucky. And that one pot of water is all that her family has for the day, for their water needs. Can you imagine 2010? Our people and administration cannot supply drinking water to the villages. What sort of a development that has taken place in 65 years of independence and 62 years of democracy? Except beating their chest and saying, I am the leader of the party. I am the neta. I think the time is coming. We all should join the movement against them. But before that, you have to be honest yourself. This is my big dream. Because I find if this change does not come, I am not the same. You. The youth, your children, they are the subjects. See the growth of zeros from 70 lakhs to 1,86,000 crores. You can't afford it. Thank you very much.